In this video, we're going to start the Mutually Exclusive Events worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Geometry section. Our directions are to determine if the scenario involves mutually exclusive events. A mutually exclusive event is also known as disjoint. It means that each event cannot happen at the same time. So, for example, think about flipping a coin. You either get heads or you get tails. You never get both on the same flip. So those are mutually exclusive events. Let's look at number one. In number one, it says a spinner has an equal chance of landing on each of its 8 numbered regions. After spinning it once, it lands either in region 3 or it lands in 6. This is mutually exclusive. And that's because it cannot both land on 3 and 6 in the same spin. It either lands on 3 or it lands on 6. And number two, it says a bag contains 6 yellow jerseys numbered 1 to 6. So we'll have yellow 1, yellow 2, yellow 3, yellow 4, yellow 5, and yellow 6. The bag also contains 4 purple jerseys numbered 1 through 4. So purple 1, purple 2, purple 3, and purple 4. It says that you randomly pick a jersey. The jersey you pick is purple or it has a number greater than 5. Is this mutually exclusive? That means there will be no overlap, or essentially the intersection will equal 0. So if it's purple, it's either P1, P2, P3, or P4. Or it has a number greater than 5, which is Y6. None of those overlap, therefore this is mutually exclusive. Now you may be questioning me and say, oh, the answer sheet on the KutaSoftware website says that they're not mutually exclusive. But I believe that's incorrect. You either pick purple or you pick a number greater than 5. The purple jerseys do not even have a number that's greater than 5, so there's no way that you'll be able to pick both at the same time. Now, if this said or the number is less than 5, then yes, it would not be mutually exclusive, because a number less than 5 is 4, 3, 2, and 1, and the purple jerseys are all labeled 1, 2, 3, and 4. Therefore, there would be some overlap or some intersection. However, it says greater than 5, which there is not a purple jersey with a number greater than 5. Therefore, it is mutually exclusive. For number 3, a magazine contains 12 pages. You open to a random page. The page number is 8 or the page number is 10. It is not possible to open to a page that's both 8 and 10. Therefore, this is mutually exclusive. In number 4, a box of chocolates contains 6 milk chocolates and 4 dark chocolates. 2 of the milk chocolates and 3 of the dark chocolates have peanuts inside. So out of the 6 milk chocolates, 2 have peanuts, and out of the 4 dark chocolates, 3 have peanuts. So you randomly select a chocolate and eat it. It is a milk chocolate, or it has no peanuts inside. Number 4 is not mutually exclusive, because it is possible to get a milk chocolate that has no peanuts, because since there's 6 milk chocolates total and only 2 of them have peanuts, then 6 minus 2, that means 4 milk chocolates do not have peanuts. So you can choose a milk chocolate that has no peanuts inside. Therefore, it's not mutually exclusive. For numbers 5 through 8, we're going to be finding the probability. And I'm going to introduce a formula for when there's a mutually exclusive event and when there's not a mutually exclusive event. So let's look at number 5. In number 5, a magazine contains 14 pages. You open to a random page. The page number is 3 or 7. This is mutually exclusive, so we're going to be using the formula P of A union B, which P of A union B can also be written as P of A or B. So the probability of A union B, so the probability of 3 or a 7 is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B. So writing that out in terms of this problem, the probability of 3 or 7 equals the probability of 3 plus the probability of opening to page 7. So the probability that you open to page 3 out of 14 pages is 1 out of 14. And the probability that you open to page 7 out of 14 pages is also 1 out of 14. 1 14th plus 1 14th is 2 14ths, which we can simplify to 1 7th, which is approximately 0.143. So 1 7th or 0.143 is our solution in number 5. And that's the probability that you get page 3 or page 7. Number 6, it says that a basket contains 3 apples, 3 peaches, and 4 pears. You randomly select a piece of fruit. It is an apple or it is a peach. This is mutually exclusive. There is no intersection between picking an apple and picking a peach. So we're going to use the formula that the probability of A union B, the probability of A or B, equals the probability of A plus the probability of B. So we have the probability of an apple or a peach equals the probability of an apple plus the probability of picking a peach. The probability of picking an apple, if there's 3 apples total out of 3 plus 3 plus 4, since there's 3 apples, 3 peaches, and 4 pears, that's a total of number of fruits, which is 10, we have 3/10 of a probability of picking an apple. The probability of picking a peach is also 3 out of 10, since there's 3 peaches out of the 10 fruits. So 3/10 plus 3/10 is 6/10, and that simplifies to 3/5, since 2 goes into both 6 and 10 evenly, which is approximately 0.6, or 6/10. And number 7, you roll a fair 6-sided die. The die shows an even number or a number greater than 3. So the numbers on a die are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So our even numbers are 2, 4, and 6, and a number greater than 3 is either 4, 5, or 6. So you can see that 4 and 6 do indeed overlap. Therefore, there's an intersection of our events, and that makes this not mutually exclusive. So I'm going to introduce a new formula. When you have events that are not mutually exclusive, the probability of A union B, so the probability of A or B, equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A intersection B, the probability of A and B. So writing this out, we'll have the probability of an even number or the probability that is greater than 3. That equals the probability of even plus the probability that it's greater than 3 minus the probability that it's even and greater than 3. So the probability that it's even, that's 2, 4, or 6. So 3 numbers out of the 6 total numbers. The probability that it's greater than 3, 4, 5, or 6 is also 3 out of the total of 6 numbers. And the probability that it's even and greater than 3 is just 4 or 6. So that's 2 out of the 6. So since we have the same denominator, we can add the numerators together over that denominator. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 minus 2 is 4. 4 sixths, we can simplify it since both of those are even numbers. 2 goes into 4 2 times, and 2 goes into 6 3 times. So 2/3 is approximately 0.667. And that's the probability of getting an even number or a number that's greater than 3. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 8. However, before I go over the answer to this, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't already, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, on to number 8. We have a box that contains 3 red playing cards numbered 1 through 3. So we'll have red 1, red 2, and red 3. The box also contains 5 black cards numbered 1 through 5. So black 1, black 2, black 3, black 4, and black 5. You randomly pick a playing card. It is black, so that's B1, B2, B3, B4, or B5, or it has an odd number. So that's R1, R3, B1, B3, and B5. So you can see that there is some overlap. Therefore, this is not mutually exclusive, so we're going to be using our formula that states that the probability of A or B equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B. Now we can use this formula anytime we have a mutually exclusive event or an event that's not mutually exclusive. However, if it's not mutually exclusive, then we will have a value for the intersection. If it is mutually exclusive, then P of A intersection B equals 0. That's why for mutually exclusive events, we can just use the first part of this formula. However, since this is not mutually exclusive, we need to take into account that intersection. So the probability of A or B is the probability of A. So the probability of A will be that it's black. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards out of the total of 8. And we're going to add that to the probability that it's odd. So that's the probability of B. So the probability that's odd is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of the 8. And we're going to subtract that intersection. So the probability that it's odd and black is 1, 2, 3 cards out of 8. So because they all have the same denominator, we can just add the numerators over 8. 5 plus 5 is 10, 10 minus 3 is 7. And 7/8 equals 0.875. That's the probability that the card is black or the card has an odd number. And if you didn't do so before number 8, like, subscribe, and share. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 9 through 18.